I think Nico is the best player I met that adapted to the new patch. He thinks a lot about the new changes, he plays a lot of solo queue, so I think he knows better than me how to play right now.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. So the final game of Super Week is here with Gambit Gaming versus Rocket. The head-to-head between these teams is currently in favor of Rocket as they lead 2-0. And honestly, the games have not been that close. Yesterday, Gambit sunk further as they lost out heavily to Millennium in a one-sided game and then came up against a brick wall in the form of Fnatic, as Alliance just found out. They will have to dig very deep to produce a result to prevent themselves going 0-4 this Super Week.
And it's a bit scary because the average game time this week for Gambit has been the lowest of all the games with 29 minutes and 26 seconds. But it's been because they've been losing so fast actually. The early game for them has been way too weak. And I feel like they need to get Diamond on an aggressive early jungler so he can make some plays before level 6, help out his lanes, because they really need it. Every single time the other jungler shows up, kills Darren a few times, and he gets no help early on, early game jungler for Diamond should be a high priority for them. Rocket, however, as a team, do like to play very passive, so we might actually see Gambit Gaming go towards the late game teamfights, and let's see if they can shine in the late game then.
Yeah, absolutely. Rocket have managed 6 wins in the last 9 games and are 2-1 in the Super Week so far, trying to tie up with Super Hokru, who went 3-1. Despite those victories, of course, being far from convincing. Still, it doesn't matter how you win, as long as you do win. Of course, their record being so positive against Gambit, they are actually the favorites coming into this matchup.
Yeah, and we can just say slow and steady wins the race, especially for Rocket here. They really love to go late game and they make sure to take no chances in the way to the late game. And they managed to pick up a lot of kills, so they are actually chasing Subaku and Millennium now, and of course looking to secure the top 6 spot for the playoffs. It's what everyone is playing for. And we have to highlight Celavar, to be honest. There's always been a lot of talk about Celavar's too weak of an AD carry, but lately he's been looking very good. He's Corki especially, 7.80 KDA on Corki. Very strong performance over the last few weeks, and if he picks Corki once again, we know he can deliver. And I honestly feel like if they win this game, we might see them next week play more aggressive, play more confident, because they've then picked up some wins in the Super Week and moved away from the bottom teams and make sure, okay, we are now in a playoff position.
Well, if they win this one, they're 7-10. That's a bloody good
It's record. Fine, yeah, exactly. Yeah.
If they can take it all the way, we'll see how it works out for them. Let's check out those starting lineups for the two teams. On the blue side, it's Gambit Gaming. That means it's Darien in the top lane, Diamond in the jungle, Nick is the mid lane, Genja on AD carry, and Edward on support.
And on the red side, we do have Rocket with Sasus in the top lane, Jankos as the jungler, Overpower in the mid lane, Celavar as AD carry, and Vandalife on support.
So those are the lineups, and let's take a look at your votes over on LOLESports.com and see who picked to win this match. According to those numbers, Rocket leads the vote by 56%. It's a crazy, crazy change over the last year that Gambit have had.
Yeah, but still, people believe 44% of the vote, even though Rocket have been looking better in the Super Week
and
the last few weeks.
They've still got a big fan base, that's
for
sure.
They do, and they are still a good team. They have some issues. I definitely feel like the team synergy kind of dropped, and they play, looks like a bit of solo queue in these games here. Some of their own decisions. Sometimes one guy goes in, the rest of the team kind of backs away. If they do manage to sit down, get some good practice in, I feel like they can get the teamwork back up, and then they will be a strong team, because they are good individually players.
The biggest thing for me with Gambit Gaming is they were the team that set the meta. They were the team that would pull out the new champions. It's been a very, very long time, and they are so slow to adapt to the meta these days. I just wonder whether they've simply, you know, they haven't got the hunger that they used to have as a team. The fact that, you know, they're not the same lineup. Maybe it's just things. Of course, we've been talking about Genja's build not being on the same page with everyone else in the world, honestly. So it's what I do worry for Gambit Gaming as a team in general. So let's get these pick and bans underway. Lee Sin has been banned out there. Kazanen, of course, taken away. We'll see how this one goes. Immediately, they've slowed down. Gambit having a good hard think about what they need to take away. It's another jungler. Yeah, that's a problem. That means it could be an Elise first pick for Gambit.
Oh yeah, it could be Evelynn first pick for Gambit, or they want to try and force Rocket to ban Evelynn as the last ban, and then first pick another top pick for them, and then maybe rely on the Skarner as the jungle pick for Diamond. If they feel confident enough in the Skarner pick and then want to first pick something like a Jax, could have been Kayle if it wasn't banned away. Lulu is definitely an option too for a first pick. unless Rocket doesn't ban away the airplane, and then we might see Gambit just take it.
We're waiting for Darien to come through with that final ban. Kale, of course, was taken out by Rocket. No surprises. Very strong champion. It is a Jax ban in that top lane. A lot of things available here. Twisted Fate being one of them, and as you mentioned, these could potentially be that first pick as well.
Evelynn, TF, Lulu, we've seen it Ziggs. Time and time again. Lucian maybe for Genja, if they want to take it away from Celebi, but he's been happy going towards Corki. Yeah. So it wouldn't really affect Rocket too much. And I'm very much looking forward to see what the last ban here for Rocket will be. If it's going to be the Evelynn, and then they try and force Diamond onto something like Skarner.
Okay, the final ban is Nami. That's an interesting one.
Well, everyone played it yesterday.
Well,
it did, but... Oh, it was okay.
It wasn't ban-worthy.
True, but it's more of a, we have a free ban now, and we actually want you to first pick Evelynn, so we get two strong picks on our side, and we have a fourth jungler ready, being a Jarvan by whatever Nocturne it is. Jankos feels like he has a different jungler ready, so now we give them Evelynn, and say we get two very strong picks. Again, could be Lucian, get it away from Genja, could be something like Shyvana, Renekton for top lane, or the Lulu pick. Ziggs has been a big champion for overpower, often early picked it, even without knowing what the other team had in the mid lane. He would just lock into Ziggs as a very high priority pick for him. So a lot of options for Rocket, and they definitely expected the Evelynn first pick, also why they waited such a long time with the last ban, and just said, you know what, let's just pick whatever random support, Nami ban.
I think the Twisted Fate and potential overpowers are...
He's a good TF player, yes.
You could even see Zaza's picking up maybe Lulu or
Ryze. Good call.
Yeah, well, Twisted Fate's kind of a given, I think, these days. It's almost become a de facto pick for those mid laners if left available.
Ever since the change to LeBlanc, where she no longer silenced on a Q, TF can actually lane against pretty much everything. He will have a hard time in some matchups, but he can farm at least and then impact the side lanes, which is all that matters. You don't have to kill people one-on-one with TF. It's all about the side lanes and then later on impacting the map with your ult. And of course, Morgana, you're one of the top supports, especially in this Super Week. And we already get a good comp here where if you land a binding, you follow up by gold card, or the other way around, you have to point and click stun from overpower, binding in from Vander, and all of a sudden you're CC'd for like 5 seconds and you are most likely dead.
Yeah, you're gonna get locked up for a long time. Yeah, but with the choices, what will they go with? Be down to Genja's choice, maybe. Hasn't been able to find his rhythm on the 4.10 patch yet. Darien in the top lane, he has definitely been having issues. Has the lowest KDA in the entire LCS, North America and Europe put together there.
And
it's
Swaglof been worse
not
over
doing
the
well
Super
in
Week.
Top.
It's been worse. He had a good game on Jax in day one, and then yesterday he was the target for a lot of ganks. Died a lot of times. Yeah. Definitely didn't help his KDA, but honestly, I don't think he cares about his KDA at all.
Of course.
Now, picked up Aurelia. It's actually been a champion. He played quite some times, but it's been very mixed. Because the thing about Aurelia is, if you do get locked down early on, you won't get your Trinity Force fast enough, and you won't get your mid-game power spike, where you are very strong in these teamfights, where you can jump people, you have the burst from the Trinity Force, and you can kill them one-on-one. So if he picks it now, and Rocket puts a lot of focus on camping him early on, delays his whole power spike, he might end up in a situation where he's just a tank and won't really be able to kill anyone.
Well, Aatrox left available. We saw Freddy playing it a couple of times. Zaza's
very strong laner.
Maybe go for that one. Celebi, he's going to be happy. Back on Lucian. He's done very well on Corki, though. He's having a fantastic Super Week, honestly, overall. Probably been the best one for him in a long time, obviously, this season.
Looked good in London, too, on Corki, so stepped up his game. Again, a lot of people used to say he was the weak link on Rocket, but really been stepping up here. And if the rest of the team can join him, we can potentially see them be like the team we saw last split, where they did get third place, beat Alliance in their very last game of the playoffs to secure the third place. But Aatrox, good laner, also become even more popular because of the built-in sustain now with the lifesteal changes, and will do well against Aurelia here early on. And been a pick for Sasus. He likes to play it, and he likes late game to just dive into the enemy team with a Guardian Angel, die once, die twice, and die a third time as well, to just be so annoying as this. Because Aatrox late game is basically just a tank who will resurrect and buy time for the team, but he has a lot of damage early on, which he can use to get an advantage.
Well, Edward was the first player to adapt and pick up Thresh in the LCS. We'll see whether he locks that in. Lulu on the side for Nick. Uses that one. Nick, of course, was one of the players that was heavily affected by the Nidalee changes. had to happen, though, and it is banned away. Global ban for the next 4 months while we see whether that champion is adjusting, of course, with the rework.
Different place now, still a very good pick now. But Lulu, so standard Gambit comp. We've seen Lulu from Nick as well this week. You have the top lane Aurelia diving in. You have, of course, the Caitlyn in the back being safe, scaling into the late game here. So Gambit looking for a very good teamfight comp late game. Still need some time to build it up, however. Caitlyn, of course, is good in the laning phase. Same goes for Lucian. But Caitlyn should have the slight advantage. But then in the mid game, we always talk about it. If Lucian goes Blade into Ghostblade, he will be strong in the mid game point where Caitlyn needs some time to build up to the late game, which is where we can see Rocket potentially punish him.
That's a face of concern from Jankos there.
Well,
sure, if he's
fair,
100% convinced by this vibe.
The normal junglers are gone, so what
he doesn't
do you
look
pick?
Happy about it, does he? That's for sure. It's the first pick in the European summer split for us, for Vi, but was a champion, honestly, the Impaler used to play a lot of back in the spring.
Dexter used it a lot in
NA. Dexter, Jankos also played it back in the spring, but this time around, he did not look very convinced by that choice.
No, you're really down to the next tier of junglers, which you have to pick up. But it will be the Vi, so we have a bit of a pick comp here, but also with a lot of siege potential for Rocket with Twisted Fate, with Lucian, Black Shield for Morgana. But at the same time, you have the gold card, you have the binding, Vi ulti, Aatrox jumping a target. If Gambit is out of position, Rocket can jump them instantly, lock them down for multiple seconds, and pick up the kills they want. Where Gambit are looking for the big team fight. You have the Lulu, you have the Aurelia, two very good team fighters, and then of course Caitlyn in the late game will be able to carry the team if you make sure she stays alive.
I'm not sure Genji's going to have a good time here. There looks like a lot that could focus towards him.
No Black Shield either.
Absolutely, nothing to block it out. With these lineups now selected, which team do you think has come out on top? Tweet us, hashtag GMBWin or hashtag ROCWin to at LOL Esports, and we'll see who you think is stronger.
So Gambit have shown this week they don't enjoy playing against pick comps, because often if they do fall behind, they tend to try and do some solo action to come back in the game, which is where it comes with Twisted Fate, of course, with Vi, just to catch you out of position. Will punish you a lot here. So Rocket, if they do get a good early start here, we might look for another game where Gambit will struggle a lot. But if they do get to late game teamfights, or just mid game teamfights, to be honest, with Aurelia, if she gets a good start, gets the Trinity Force early on, Gambit can definitely bite back.
We'll see whether their gamble of banning out the jungles works out for them. They went for two of them. We tried to get the Holy Trinity locked in. They managed to steal away that Elise. We'll see whether it works in their favor, ladies and gentlemen. The final game of Super Week getting underway. It is the power of Gambit up against Rocket. And currently, Gambit are chasing Rocket in the table. Gambit must pick up a win here to stop this disastrous Super Week.
Especially with the Wolves picking up the win against the Lion Tears. Now they're closing in on Gambit as well, and you really don't want to get their last place. You want to have a choice, at least just one choice, in which team you want to face in the relegation. For now, Gambit actually moving very aggressively towards the blue buff of Rocket here. Celavi is ready to scout, will of course not be able to see Diamond, so he can see him. Maybe Edward will try hook if Celavi moves too close. But again, Darien is always the target whenever Gambit plays. You often see the jungler move up and try and kill Darien multiple times. Jankos can try and do the same thing in this game. Aatrox can set it up very easily. Land your slow, land your knock-up, and then Vi comes in. And the thing about Vi is, most junglers in Europe at least are like, yeah, she's a bit too weak before level 6. So if I get invaded on by something like an Evelynn, if she catches me out at a camp, I will die. And you want this level 6 before you do the best possible ganks with Vi, but her damage is not bad before level 6, and she can still make something.
So, change around in the lanes. You can see Darien come down. He doesn't want to go for a 4-man invade on the blue here, I feel. And Rocket, they could react. They can quickly switch straight across, of course, because there's no one to stop them. And it seems that Gambit, so they might actually sneak in unseen.
Yeah, no wards from Rocket. Didn't place anything. Celavi did have his ward. Didn't place it. So, Gambit will take this blue buff. Question is, will Jankos figure it out and move to Gambit's blue buff afterwards? Otherwise, it's going to be two blue buffs for Gambit.
Oh, Diamond, Darien, and Edward are on it. They've got the ward around the side, so we'll keep our eyes on where Jankos follows off after this one. Diamond is going to take away that blue. He's cleared out. Overpower taking some damage in the mid lane. Pulls a good blue on towards Nick there. That's maximum damage. Didn't go for the stun, of course. Only pulls a red card this time. I'll have to keep her eye on that one. Oh, Diamond getting a little bit greedy here, going for the walls, but look at Jankos. Yeah. Need to make a move coming across. He could find his entire jungle has been stolen away.
So they might have seen Genji and Edward move from the blue buff down to this bottom lane and therefore figured out the blue was gone now, and also it would be too late to even move for the blue buff.
Ignite used. It's not going to be enough to take him down, but it's going to be enough to force him away for now. But look, Jankos has come around. He's realized
double blue buff for
nothing
Gambit
here.
Double blue buff for Gambit here. Just checking. Okay, it's gone. Cleared. It's gonna. He will have the timer. He knows they took it instantly, so just a standard timer for the buff. But still, it's going to be two blue buffs for Gambit here. Diamond will be very happy.
Yeah, very happy. Good start for him. Maybe that gamble of punishing the jungle bans is paying off for him already, putting Jankos clearly into an uncomfortable position.
And again, Jankos really wants to get his level 6 point before he can do the deadly ganks we know from Vi. So it's going to slow him down quite a lot, actually losing a buff early on. He is basically just looking to farm now. The mana is fine for him, but Diamond already moving in for the gank. Didn't take the blue buff yet.
Has yet to go around. Once no flash. Towards Overpower. Flash was burned early on. They may catch on towards him. Overpower's in trouble. That's going to be first blood. It's Diamond that takes it.
Such a good setup here. Diamond coming in early, already level 4 here. So he's very far ahead compared to Jankos. Double buff, everything. Flash onto Overpower. Had to use the flash earlier with the very aggressive trades from Nick.
Diamond is not done yet. He doesn't care about his own blue buff. He's coming around to Zazas. Zazas has flash available, but he's very deep on this one. Comes around the side, catches on towards him. The red buff will get the slowdown on towards him. Zazas in trouble. Can he pop the Bloodwell? He should be able to catch him.
One,
and the one more hate spike should be enough. There's the Bloodwell going down from Zazas.
It's a very good start by Diamond here. And this is what we talk about, early game junglers for Diamond, so he can set up some plays, help his laners. Nick played very aggressive, got the help from Diamond, so they got the kill. And overall, a lot better start from Gambit this game, from what we've seen in this Super Week.
Yeah, good stuff. Gambit on track early on, but it's been a rough, rough Super Week for them, and that may well be in the back of their minds. Genji and Edward, they're starting to push Vanda and Sulliva back a little bit here, putting the pressure down with this Caitlyn Thresh combo.
Pushing them into the tower. Sulliva missed the two last years and took him. Q to the face as well here, so good poke from Gambit, and keep pushing the lane in every single time they have the chance.
Genji continuing to keep the pressure on, of course. Overpower now back in this mid lane, got himself a second door in his ring. Boots were also picked up by Nick on his back, so he has an advantage against him. Ward going in place to make sure he gets vision of the race, and now Diamond finally, with that blue buff worn off, he's going to come around and get it. It's going to delay the spawn, obviously, for Nick, but he has the title.
And it means Diamond can now just keep running around the jungle and clear it very, very fast. And the ward from Overpower, of course, always the trick against Evelynn. Place it so you can see the cam, so you can see her start the cam and get out of stealth. But level 5 on Diamond already, and now moving in towards Jankos. If he starts the raves here, he might be in trouble. Oh, he doesn't have any wards on him. So
I'm wondering whether he's worried about it. He's going to try and peek around there. Hasn't been spotted. Overpower's being very cautious. Still hasn't seen, of course, Diamond at those rates. Does go forward a little bit. Nick goes aggressive. Picks his on towards him. Gets the Glitter Lance down. Diamond, though, quickly stunned up with a yellow card. Overpower knew what was coming.
Once again, his bot lane though, Edward going very aggressive.
Good flay on towards him, he takes a lot of the damage. Genji not able to get the hits down. The ignite from Vanda may well be enough to close him down. He can't get on towards him.
Oh, I almost stuck into it.
Quite catching, and Eddie just at the last minute steps to the side.
Saved the flash, he didn't want to use the Diamond once again around his mid lane.
Comes back on towards him, it's another cold card, only the hate spike catching on from Diamond. Not enough damage on that.
Jankos coming down to his bot lane, only level 5 here. He can still get onto Edward, he's very low.
Eddie's in trouble. Oh, good flash from Edward. Avoids the damage, but he quickly gets caught out. The shield gets thrown out, and Edward's safe.
Very nice flash here, Edward getting away. Genji had to use the heal as well to make sure to kite away after Jankos actually flashed. So no flash for the jungler of Rocket here. Nothing else was actually used from Rocket's side. And Diamond once again sneaking around, looking for Jankos.
He knows he's going to be down the bottom here. He's going to find him. He's actually full of hit points, though. He's going to back away. He'll have full vision. I think he'd adjusted him around there, of course.
Didn't ping it, though.
Blue buff will be back up in around about 30 seconds' time. I think Jankos is going to be back in time.
Well, with Overpower being a bit behind here in this mid lane, Gambit might look to start a fight if Diamond can get level 6 before the blue buff spawns. Doesn't seem like he actually wants to farm for it. He's staying around this mid lane. If they do get a kill on Overpower now, it means he won't be level 6 and they can move straight to the blue buff afterwards.
Look at Diamond waiting just off of the side there. Actually pinged it just off the side. He's like, I think something's around here, I'm worried. There's the blue buff spawning. Nick's keeping track of him. There was a ward down there, so they know Jankos has just come
back. Oh, the pink.
Puts the pink on top of his head. Nicely played, Rocket.
Well, at least Gambit know where the pink will be. You can see Diamond staying around still. He wants to clear it out. Jankos, again, he's not level 6. He won't really be able to jump him. So, it's, yes, you spotted out the Evelyn, but you invested 100 gold in it, and now it's gone.
Yeah, puts the ward back on top, though. There's the blue buff, and that's going to get picked up. Overpower should take it with the wild cards. There we go. So, Rocket finally get themselves their first blue buff. Diamond, he's still hanging around.
He's going towards the red buff now here. See if he can catch Jankos. Not level 6 yet, gave the blue buff the overpower, of course. And Diamond staying around. He does have a ward. He can place it to red buff and try and maybe smite it away. Nick joining in too.
The thing is, this is the Diamond of old. This is the Diamond.
Yes, this is why we like him early jump.
This is what he did. He was the aggression. Overpower, having to use Destiny to get vision of him.
Realize he's going
in trouble. He's going for Diamond here. Catches him with a pink overpower. Nick cannon jumps on towards him with the wild growth. Diamond going to get locked up. Still, Jankos not hit level 6. And now Darion comes around the side. There's a lot of damage though coming out from Rocket. They're forcing Gambit back.
Nick here, so let's flash, we'll use it. Gold card land afterwards. Oh, Jankos going in.
Doesn't quite catch on towards him. Jankos taken low, he gets dropped instead. Darion catches on towards him. The blood well on there. Darion so, so low, he's going to get locked up. Overpower one more hit point. Diamond runs him down. And now Zazas is dropped as well. This has all gone horribly wrong for Rocket.
Again, we keep talking about it, but Jankos, he wasn't level 6. He still went in for it. Gambit instantly turned it around. Picked up the kill, managed to pop the passive from Sasa as well and take him out, but Genji in trouble.
Good black shield from Vander there, stop the flay from Edward. He's going to catch on towards him, but look at this, the Ignite going down. Eddie goes full on aggression, takes the whole kill in the Ignite running, not going to be enough. And now Vander tries to turn it back around.
So many fights early on here. Jungler's been involved, bot lane fighting against each other. Even the top laners came down from the top lane to this mid lane to fight. Wind in favor of Genji. We're just going to see it again here. Opal goes in very aggressive with the ult, but the rest of Rocket joins in. Darion coming in as well, and now they're just kiting backwards from the side of Gambit. Down is very low, they want to disengage at first until the level 5 Jankos with only 50% HP over chase. Nick flashes, Jankos goes in very squishy this time, they turn around, he's dead instantly. And from here on, they just try and go for the last few kills. Diamond onto Overpower, no flash, will manage to pick him up, and Sazas. He got a kill, ended up dying afterwards.
They lined up perfectly for Nick's clip.
Yeah, it was purple.
Every of them. Straight across. Happy. He's killing them like they were minions, honestly. And that gives him a big advantage in that mid lane. You can see CS-wise ahead, and of course, kill-wise way ahead now. That gives him a 400 gold advantage built up over them. So, these top laners, we haven't had a good chance to look at them, of course. We did see the Blood Well being popped by Zazas. He did go down, as did Darion. Dragon is going to get started out by Gambit here, and honestly, they're going to take it.
No wards from Rocket, nobody's even pinging it or moving the ulti from Opal to actually spot it, so will be an easy dragon for Gambit, keeping the control of the early game. But yeah, top lane, Aatrox is a very strong laner, so doing well early on here, picking up a lot of farm for Sassus and going towards the Blade of the Rune King, where we of course see the Trinity Force from Darion, and most likely will build tank afterwards and then focus on some of these mid-game teamfights. Also with the fact that Gambit are ahead now in the early game, so they can actually force some of these mid-game teamfights.
Render finding himself a pink ward in the river. It's a futile task for supports, as we heard, of course, Yellowstar talking about.
Yeah.
It's a tough life for supports in this game, but you've got to take every advantage, and he certainly has this week. Right now, the two supports of Edward and Vander trying to keep their AD carries alive. It's been a close, close battle, and we've yet to see a kill in this bot lane, but we may see one coming shortly.
He's on a ward though, Jankos, so they know exactly where he is. Obviously, they can still die if they get locked down by the ult and a binding afterwards. And instead of actually building Blade of the Rune King here, and Lucian, I like it a lot. You try and use it for the mid game here for Rocket as well.
Again, Jankos down the bottom, stood on top of wards, using his jungle diamond.
Yeah.
So you're down there and taking everything. Jankos is actually coming back up towards his top lane. And he's going to suddenly realize I've got nothing left again. Zazas hasn't got Bloodwell available and he's pretty low on hit points. Hasn't got Flash either. So if Darion can bait him in here, this is a problem. We see Jankos desperately trying to close the distance. He's going to come around towards him, jumps back on towards the tower. Diamond contact now.
Zazas managed to get away. Gambit didn't want to dive, didn't have any wards or control of where Jankos was. And Opal as well with the ult could have joined in and prevented everything. He actually still looking for the ult.
Yeah, Diamond used Agony's Embrace in that last engage. Flashes away. Darion caught with a slow, the stun card. No, just timed out from Overpower. He was holding it for so long.
Very low on mana, actually. No blue buff. And Nick just pushing in the mid lane now. Zero kills for Rocket up in his top lane.
This is the problem. Every time Overpower goes away, he's getting punished on that tower. It is slowly but surely being whittled down by Nick. He's making sure he gets the aggression on that one. That's going taken down. Back in the top lane, we see him flashing in there. But this bottom lane, oh, it's dangerous. That's going to be a bad dart. Binding Soul Shackles not going to be used by Vander.
I think
he could have taken that one. He's still got Soul Shackles available and Ignite. No, he just used it and missed it. It was out of range.
Vander,
Edward flashes in for that one and doesn't get anything down. Instead, dies.
And Sasu's joining in. Genji without his flash.
Uh-oh, caught by
Diamond
the slow.
Is close, though.
Diamond's going to come in, but I'm not sure he's going to save his AD carry. Nick will, though. There's the wild growth. And now Zazas with his wild. He's Bloodwell back available.
Oh, coming
Genji
through.
Gets caught out there. Yankos on towards him. Now Nick's in trouble. Genji gets locked down. Assault and battery on him. Nick going to get away. No, he gets caught out. And suddenly there's three deaths for Gambit.
So while Rocket were over aggressive early on, now it was Gambit's turn. Edward, he flashed forward. Binding in his head, Ignite afterwards, he went down, and then everyone from Rocket just joined in while Gambit sent in Diamond, sent in Nick to try and help, and everyone ended up dying. 5 kills now for Rocket, pushing down this mid lane, but won't be able to take it, of course. They did lose the top tower, however. Darion didn't have teleport, so he didn't actually join in for the fight.
Yeah, didn't come down there, but that whole play, I hate to say it, came from Edward making a misplay.
It was, he flashed forward,
yeah. For it, and then suddenly, from a 4-1 to a 5-4 for Rocket, they now have the advantage. They are slightly behind in gold, but all of the great work that Diamond put in early on has just been undone with that one little play.
It was also a good TP by Sasus. Coming down, as soon as Edward flashed forward, he joined in. And then all of a sudden, Gamer were just caught in the river, actually. He couldn't really move anywhere. Opa was coming from one side with Yankers. The rest of Rocket was coming down from the bottom side, just collapsing on and killing them. And even the gold out pretty well here, even though we had such a good start from Gambit.
He's in the hole, not going to get blocked out by that flex shield.
Blade completed on Silver. Looking to be very strong now for the next 10 minutes or so until we get in Fintech and a second item on the side of Genji.
There's a big power difference in the mid lane between Nick. Ooh, Yankos trying to collapse on towards Diamond. Between Nick and Overpower. You can see Morel, Nomicon, and Source Boots already completed, whereas Overpower yet to get that Fiends. And actually,
one more.
Nope. He's just trying to get the basic attacks down.
Got it. Tower. And that's the thing here again with the comps, because Irelia late game will be able to do a lot more damage than Aatrox. However, Aatrox again with the passive can revive, come back up to life here. But then you have Caitlyn, who again will outscale Illusion, so Gambit do have the option to just play it safe and wait for the late game points. But because Nick is so far ahead, we might see them force something early on here. It will be risky though, especially because we do have to play it on Celebus. He's going to be very strong in these mid game fights, and of course Aatrox will also be strong in these fights.
Well, Trinity Force has already been completed by Darion, so he's
looking good.
Doing pretty well in this build in 15 minutes. He's heading back towards that top lane, of course, got himself a kill and assist early on. He's going to protect this tower. We're not going to see Zazas being able to take that one down. Neither have got flash available at the moment. The dragon is up in just side of a minute. I think Darion will have his teleport available when the dragon falls.
Notice Overpower on the minimap. He stayed at his tower. He waited to move anywhere. He didn't want to show himself. He wants Gambit to be afraid of him ganking somewhere. So he's just staying all the way over the tower. And also because of the lack of wards for him, if he actually moved out here to try and clear the wave, Diamond could have been there, collapsed onto him, and try to kill him. For now, nothing actually happened, even though both junglers was in the bot lane. Back to farming for everyone. Dragon in about 15 seconds should be the big thing now.
Well, Pink Ward's going to get found out. Vander will catch that. That's going to clear vision away from Gambit. Ooh, tell her why. He's going to walk in. Vander's quickly panicked.
Clear the ward.
Got a pink ward in there himself, so Nick will clear that one out. And that means Gambit now in position.
Taking full control.
Dragon spawning in a second. Rocket are going to have to fight for it. Looks like Zaz is happy to take the top turret instead in the front.
Good start though for Gambit. They got in, cleared the pink ward, cleared the wards from Rocket. Made sure they have no wards to actually see what's going on, and therefore they can take it. And as you just said, trade it for the top tower.
Yeah, mid turret had a bit of damage. Overpower managed to get a wave shoved in there. That's going to get cleared out no problem by Nick. So at the moment, Dragon Control is in hands of Gambit, but this game's still very tight. Just 1,000 gold separating the two. Bottom lane has shown a lot of aggression between the two, but we didn't see too many kills except for that one big play, which honestly swung it heavily in favor of Sullivan, who is himself already got that Blade of the Ring completed, so he's going to have an earlier power spike, I guess, against Genji, who clearly is going for that instant edge once again.
Yeah. Well, it's the right choice. Caitlyn, he has been farming well here, even though he died once. Yango's joining in to this bot lane. Doesn't really get any ganks on. Just managed to push out the wave for now. Multiple members pushing down this tower here. Gambit backing away.
Yeah, that tower's going to go down. It's Rock out second of the game. And it is a much needed one. They're fighting hard for it down there. Meanwhile, Darien trying to protect the top lane, but Zazas is doing a good job against him. How do we rate them? I mean, you said that obviously Aurelia is going to become stronger, but Zazas is going to be the split push force. We've seen it a lot of times by him. Of course, he's on Aatrox, got the teleport available. Will he be able to keep up with Darien though on Aurelia?
Well, at least in split push and one-on-one, he should be. But for team fights is where Aurelia late game really shines. Again, your passive with the tenacity makes you so hard. It makes it so hard to stop you from getting to your carries every single time, and you can just go in there, try and burst them down, and as long as you get some tankiness with it, you will be able to survive, and you only need the Trinity Force for damage item in these team fights to go towards the squishy targets. But split boost wise, Aatrox is looking strong. It's still a bit of a weird champion. It's actually only Europe who really uses Aatrox, and if you talk to the top laners, it's all like, yeah, he's good in lane, and then late game, he's just very annoying, once again with the passive and everything. So it's normally the response you get when you ask the top laners, why do you like Aatrox? So much about it is about this early game power he brings.
Well, they tried to make a gank in the top lane. Quick teleport from Zazas gets him out of there. Darien having to use his teleport to counteract and defend out that mid lane. Look at him trying to go immediately aggressive. Diamond was looking to flank. They're not going to get it. Simply clear and defend the tower.
Celebar keep pushing on down his bottom lane. Gainer did complete the Infinity Edge, and we do actually see Celebar going towards Ghostblade as the second item. Once he completed, we could see Rocket try and set up some fights. Catch Gambit a bit out of position. Remember, there's no Black Shield or anything to stop Yangus from picking a target or the gold card from landing. We should also see if Edward actually wants to build Mikhail's, even though it is changed and cost a lot more, just to have the cleanse in case someone like Gendia gets caught out of position. Obviously, it doesn't work against Yangus, but against the Twisted Fate, it will. And normally, you would actually see the AD carry pick cleanse against Twisted Fate and Morgana, because again, there's such a high chance of you getting locked up and just dying.
Blue buff spawns, Rocket move in. Gambit a little too late on the timers on that one, and Overpower will claim that. So both these teams farming out. It is the final game of Super Week, of course. 16 more games coming to you from North America starting tomorrow over the next 3 days. Big, big matches going off over there, of course. Almost a 5-way tie in the top of the table in North America. It's like EU was last split.
Switching around a little bit. We've got some more dominant teams in Europe now. But I actually do feel like Millennium, Subaru, of course Fnatic, if you want to put them in the group, has been improving a lot and catching on to SK Gaming and Alliance as well. So we get some close games now between the top teams. Potentially some ties. We love them.
Yeah, I mean the first two, of course, SK and Alliance going 2-2 this week. Of course, we'll make ground. Super Hot Crew 3-1. Of course, Fnatic 4-0. They're all gaining ground on them. Millennium have slipped a little bit this weekend, of course.
But it's what they do. I mean, they play so well all of a sudden. Next game, everything just goes completely wrong for them. So they are a hard team to predict. And the same goes for playoffs. I mean, you don't know which Millennium team will show up in the playoffs. As long as they qualify to it, of course. It's not 100% yet.
No, okay. Long way to go yet still. Just over the halfway split. 7 weeks into this season, the regional playoffs await, and then the world championships, of course, that you guys have all seen announced. Three stops all over the world. We're covering Asia quite spread. Overpower with the red card, not going to work out for him. Well, I think he wanted the red card, actually. Wild cards out. So these two teams have been in a little bit of a passive mode after the early aggression we saw from both the junglers. Trying to get involved. Bottom lane was where it all went tragically wrong from Gambit. Started off well, 4-0, I think 4-1 for a while, but Rocket have returned a number of kills to get themselves back in this game. And it's actually slowed Gambit down. They had a good advantage early on. They thought they'd managed to put Yankos in a tough spot, a tough bind. But the fact that he's now on.
And now to look for place.
Found a good ward. That's going to stop it. Everything safe. Rocket step away. It's going to be the tower for Gambit. Nonetheless, that's going to be the third tower of the game. Give themselves a bit of an advantage there with the dragon spawning in 30 seconds time.
Actually staying alive. Yep. Still, they backed away. It did mean they got some wards once again around the dragon, the entrance to river as well, so they can spot Rocket moving in and setting up for the dragon spawning here in 21 seconds. Darren actually moving back to the top lane. His teleport isn't just ready yet, so he won't be able to join in case Rocket starts the dragon instantly. And they are staying around with multiple members, Sasuke as well, joining in. Blue buff too, they might just rush this one.
Should be off cooldown.
Why is Diamond recalling?
In a second, if Diamond... Well, that's that then. That's Rocket's dragon if they go straight for it. If they go straight for it.
But they do, of course.
Can delay. Of course they go straight for it. Perfect timing. And that's going to be the dragon for Rocket. So Gambit, little off on that one. Death Hunter's not going to get the steal.
Well, that was pretty weird. They moved into the river. Five members put up some wards to try and spot Rocket. Moved to the bot tower, didn't actually take it, backed away, and then everyone just backed away. Darren returned to the top lane, Diamond recalled to base, and actually just gave off a dragon, which they were in a good position to fight for, over to Rocket. Still looking just to farm passively. We talk about it often with the AD carries. Silva would have been stronger at the moment with his blade. Still need the ghost blade to be really strong here for this Mickey point, but not enough for me to think that Gambit should just give up the dragon without any fight.
Mid laners both went for that Lich Bane, so they continue to go. Mercury Treads were picked up by Overpower, by the way. So he's going to make sure he can clear himself of anything. A little bit of resistance in there. Looks like Genji's going to go towards Phantom Dancer. Actually, maybe Static Shift probably for a Kaylin.
Could be both. I mean, Static Shift gives some more wave clear if you want it. And then he just cues the wave and then Static Shift afterwards and he will instantly kill some of the minions.
Ooh, Edward caught out here. Dark Binding lands on towards him. Jankos quickly goes in towards him. Assault battery used, but Wild Growth will counter it. And now Vanda has to flash away. Jankos joins the fight. Overpower comes around the side with his Destiny as well. Diamond locked up inside there. Sulliver trying to put the damage back down. Gambit re-engaged back on towards Sulliver. Edward's going to have that lock up in a moment. The rest of Rocket continue to chase Diamond off the side there. There's going to be the final card coming out from Overpower, and it's Rocket that come out on top, 1-0.
And it was Rocket starting the fight here. They used everything they had on to Edward. Wild Growth was used by Nick to keep him alive, and the rest of Gambit came in here, but Rocket still managed to pick up a kill. Though a lot of the members are very low and had to flush away from this fight, so a lot of summoners used, and only one kill over to the side of Rocket.
Yeah, we saw Vanda getting away with next to no help there. The two mid laners get themselves, it was an unusually large run for Nick. Judging by the gold he just spent. Bit of a difference though, actually. It's going to be building towards the Zonias, of course, for Overpower, and also picking up the Distortion Boots.
Oh, Distortion Boots. One thing I'm a very big fan of on Twisted Fate, because you normally run Flash and Ghost, so you buff both of them, become stronger, reduce the cooldown as well on both your summoners. It simply makes you a lot more mobile, and it's good to get it early on as well, so you can make plays around the map. Once his cooldowns are actually ready, because it doesn't work if they're already on cooldown when you actually buy it, which is a bit annoying. You need to wait for them to be ready for them. But still, going towards the Hourglass as well as the next item. So in case Darien dives onto him, he will have the Hourglass to keep him alive. And it also means he can actually set up fights by himself. Jump into the back line, stun the first target, and then pop your Hourglass, and then the rest of the Rocket just jumps in with him. Nick, still being very aggressive here. Great game on Lulu so far. Picked up some early kills. Very good on farm as well.
Early aggression. They may even try and collapse on towards Sulliver. Yeah, look, the immediate call comes out. He backs away. Doesn't want to get caught out in the lane too far. They just moved in there. Sulliver goes back to base. And Gambit get themselves a little bit of positional control, but there's no objectives to be had. Nobody really making open plays for the inner turrets, let alone the two outer turrets that are still standing.
Everyone just farming Gambit. They want more farm on Genji before they're looking for team fights. And Rocket seems to just be looking for the one opening where Gambit is out of position and then try and catch on to them. Twisted Fate with by everyone. Jumping in. Genji, of course, just keep farming, picking up all everything he can in the jungle too. Really looking towards his next item, which will synergize well with the Infinity Edge, unless he goes back and buys a Trinity Force, which only gives 10% crit to the Infinity Edge.
Rocket, this time around, are moving across. We are at the 26 minute mark. Baron is not beyond comprehension, so that's why they're starting to ward and gain some vision around there. Gambit himself's got good vision down the bottom. Nobody pushing on towards that bottom outer turret. Edward once again. Wild Growth used very early from Nick there. That may actually trigger something for Rocket.
So I'm not sure if he was expecting everyone from Rocket to just collapse onto Edward. But there is two Bladed Rune Kings on the side of Rocket, so they should be able to do Baron very fast if they catch someone from Gambit out of position. Bro, Jankos going in.
Assault Battery going deep for Nick there on towards him. Overpower comes in with the gold card, lacks it up on towards Darien. He's going to drop down. It's Vander that gets the kill there with the end of the Soul Shackles.
And this is how you can start fights as Rocket every single time. Again, there's no Black Shield from Gambit. There's no cleanse to actually... There's nothing to stop Yankers from going in. The cleanse, of course, wouldn't help anything. So Rocket could start the fight, pick up a kill. But once again, it was actually only one kill. And now they're backing away. Didn't manage to get anything. The dragon wasn't up. They couldn't actually push down the mid tower with a lot of wave clear with both Genji and Nick. So they got a kill. Now back the way and waiting once again. Dragon 1 minute. We did, however, see the idea from Rocket. Waiting for someone from Gambit to overextend in the lane and then just collapse onto them. Kill them. Hopefully get an objective. If they can get multiple kills, they should be able to push a tower or the Baron. Again, we talked about how double plated of the Rune King. Works really well against the Baron here. Sans is once again in the side lane, split pushing.
Dragon's going to be spawning in 30 seconds time. Oh, Diamond's going to try and sneak up to Vanna. Doesn't protect the ping wall. Vanna gets it in this. Sweat straight out. So, Rocket have themselves an advantage moving in towards this Dragon fight. They have their ultimates not quite available. Assault Battery's going to have cooldown in just a second. So I expect them with the timer to go for this one once again. Teleport available for Tarrant Darien as he pushes that top lane, but more importantly, Genja, he's down the bottom. This dragon's going to spawn in 7 seconds. He's finally moving.
He's moving. He's moving. And complete fend dancer. Yankers, oh, almost went for Nick here. Decided not to do it. Darien actually used the teleport now to join in. We could see Gambit look for a fight.
A little bit early on that one. He's just going to instead teleport in and clear the wards.
Well, the same thing as before, where they get all the wards away and then move towards the dragon. There's, of course, the ulti from Overpower to use if they want to get some vision and see where Gambit is actually moving. And Yankers once again charging up.
Trying to get that Vault Breaker charged, but instead goes in towards the dragon. Dodges away from that death sentence. Vanda does throw out that dart binding. He splits off the side, actually. He could flash and engage with his Soul Shackles. It would be a ballsy move. He was looking towards maybe making that play, but Rocket instead have bullied them away from the pit right now and started the dragon.
Starting up, Gambit moving in, Overpower on the top of your screen here. He will be able to teleport in. Here's the fight!
Oh, Darien goes in. Wild Growth not quite used on towards him. You can see he's taken all of the cooling damage. Zazzas' Bloodwell has been used. There's the Wild Growth being used. He went on to Diamond. Yankos gets focused on. Good Zhonya's coming out straight away from Nick there. Didn't focus on picking in that one. You can see Darien locking in towards it. Salivar caught out. He's going to get locked down. Nick gets him with the final Glitter Lance. And that means Gambit now have the advantage as they take the dragon.
And we really saw the power here of Irelia in these fights, jumping in, took the entire calling, stayed alive, and Overpower. He didn't use his ult. He ghosted all the way from outside of our picture now. He's actually going to ghost, trying to run in here. We see Darien, first of all, going in with Diamond. They're tanking up everything. Sides drop low. Now Overpower joins in with the ghost. He has no impact in this fight because Nick, instantly after the ult from Yankos, pops the Outlast, and Overpower is now forced to run away. Gambit winning the team fight. Rocket now being out of position. Very strange that Overpower didn't join the fight earlier.
Yeah, he was just out of position.
He had ult and everything.
Completely made use of that one. Was not in there. Didn't have Zhonya's Hourglass completed as Nick did. So maybe he just got so confident in that fight. Nevertheless, gives Gambit another dragon. They're still behind in gold though. Rocket continuing to keep the pressure on with their farm across the lanes.
A little bit surprised Nick was the target. We talked about how there was nothing to stop their Vi ult before. Now with the Outlast completed, well, you Vi ult me. Unless you stun me instantly before I have time to use the Outlast, I will get it off and stay alive. Genji instead could have been the target. Of course, there would have been the Wild Growth from Nick, but it would at least be an easier target to lock down than a champion with Outlast at this point.
Well, we talked about it with the Super Art crew against Millennium, you know, how having a Lulu when there's a pick comp team looking to just single someone out, yeah, it's so vital. We saw the Wild Growth being used this time on Diamond. Zhonya's Hourglass and himself, he's like, focus me, I don't care. I'm just going to Zhonya's, and he stopped the gold card, of course, coming through.
Basically made Opal useless in the fight. He ran in, tried the gold card, nope, run out, and the fight was already lost. Also because Darien and Diamond are so strong at this point. They went in, tanked all the damage from Rocket, and did a lot of damage on Zaz as well, while Nick and Genya was just staying back and firing away all the time. And now once again, Rocket moving forward. We might see them look for a kill. Opa actually used ulti.
Yeah, Destiny was used to catch a glimpse of Gambit. Opa is actually going to the backside, and that may give Gambit the chance to go in. Jankos goes very deep all on his own. He's going to get singled out here. He's taking a lot of damage in the front there. Diamond tanking all the damage as well. Jankos taking very, very low. We see just across the side there, Zaza's trying to jump away. He's not got Bloodwell available. It's a very messy fight for everyone involved. Nick's going to focus on towards Celebrate. He's in the hole. Just blocked out in the last second. But we see Zaza's going down. Darien's going to close in. He's going to be able to Blade Surge onto them any second now. Onto Salva. Can't quite
count.
Go for the minion. Captain got towards him. Shuts him down. Vander now the focus target. He's going to tank this one out. The shields are not quite enough, and he doesn't feel like tanking it. They're going to go for the turret instead.
So this time, Jankos actually went for Genja, but he was all alone. The rest of Rocket were far away. Opa already teleported to the opposite side of the mid lane. And now, Gambit going towards this Baron here, or are they just trying to bait it out?
Well, they may try and bait it out. You're going to see the death sentence not going to land, and Gambit will not get a single objective from that one, and they are going to have to back off. They got two kills. They're still behind in goal.
Still behind in goal, but they are playing the team fights a lot better than Rocket are at the moment. Rocket seems very uncoordinated in picking the target. Jankos locked onto Genja. Overpower was far away. Ulti was already used. Nobody joined in, so Wild Groove onto Genja. He's dead alive, and then he just flashed over the wall the second time once their next wave of damage actually came in. We're just going to see it again here. Opa already used the ult, remember. So Jankos goes in. Celebrite's the only one doing some damage to Genja, but it's only the calling. Up in the top side, Opa and Vandal is fighting against Darien. So Genja, he's perfectly fine at the moment. Even though he was the focus, they split up the damage so much, and they're completely out of position. So with the Lantern, with the Flash, with the Wild Growth, it was just easy for Gambit to keep Genji alive and then chase him. We're just going to see Darien, of course, pick up the very last kill in the end.
Just chase him. Catches him out. So they didn't actually get an objective from that fight. They didn't go for the Baron because it would have been a risky play. They've been caught out with those risky plays before, actually, the last few times. So we see Genji, he's going to head off down the bottom, take himself that gigantic wave of farm. I wonder, is that going to be a last whisper?
It is. I'm going to say it's going to be a last whisper. He actually started to build it in the end, so credit to Genji. And he's been playing really well for Gambit. He's been probably the best member for Gambit, actually, together with Nick. They have been performing pretty consistently throughout the entire season. Diamond now going on to Celebrate. He's been a very big game as well.
Putting a lot of damage down on him. Hasten, a hole will burn him down as well. Now Zaza's hooked in. Bloodwell just come out. And now it immediately goes straight back down. He's going to try and jump away and not going to get caught out. Genja gets himself the first kill of the game.
Another easy kill for Gambit, just catching Rocket out of position. Now pushing up towards this mid tower. Diamond moving around. Might look for something more here. Still has ulti in case he wants to flank around. But it should at least be a tower. Maybe one more actually for Gambit.
Yeah, Gambit are going to keep on pushing through with that top lane and not available for the next 30 seconds. They have a good 4-on-5 advantage and they could get some good damage down on towards his turret. That dead sensors could try and be a setup there. You can see just off the side, Overpower with that gold card, desperately wanting to catch onto someone. Instead, Gambit will peel away. Dragon spawns in 50 seconds. They could get themselves some good vision. Instead, they know that that fight is impending and will back off and buy.
Backing away here. Doesn't have too much gold at least. Oh, actually 2,000 gold on Nick, and Jankos once again moving around. Darien all alone here. Opa might join in.
They're going to try and focus on Darien. He's
Nick
gonna
is coming.
Get locked up. Nick getting bounced around there. Quickly gets the wild growth on towards him. Glitterlands perfectly used from Nick there. Another stun on Darien. Not enough to take him down.
So all from Jankos was used. All from Opa was used as well. Nick managed to come in with the wild growth, and Darien wasn't even close to going down here. Gambit once again can go for the dragon if they want in 15 seconds or so, but they're actually pushing up this mid lane once again.
Cameron Pitt trying to chase on towards Zaza's there. Nick starting to create a lot of plays, honestly, for Gambit here. Nick starting to become that middle.
He's been everywhere.
That they need right now, of course. That Aleksic stepped away back in the spring, and Nick coming in, and he's honestly been pretty good. It's
yes,
not really been down to him that the problems have been Gambit. It's just been overall as a team.
Bit of a nervous start from Nick, but then he really pulled it together and been playing really, really well. And as we talked about in the pregame for Gambit, they are very, very good players. It just seems like the teamwork, the synergy hasn't been there. Again, they travel a lot, they lose a lot of practice time, it's hard to keep it going. It's been an issue for them before with all the traveling, and then they start boot camping and they kind of fix all the issues and become very, very strong. So picking up a win here, if they do manage to do that, would be huge for them going towards the playoff, because they really want to secure this top 6 spot.
Darien trying to bait out It's all on battery from Jankos this time around, not falling through. It hasn't got it available either, to be honest. Darkbinder did not land. We did see the bottom outer turret, going down to Genja, finally catching on towards that last whisper, now being picked up by Genja as his third item. Hallelujah.
Look at Edward here, double giant belt.
I've got him as my flex player. He needs to do well.
Well, he's been giving some pretty good points, actually.
Yeah.
Well, I have a lot of members from Fnatic, so my week is pretty good. I'm playing Joe, actually. I believe I'm stomping him at the moment.
That's unfair. He can't react to that one. As it is, Gambit are looking to try and create an upset here. Would it be an upset?
Oh,
not really.
Ulti coming in.
Destiny used. It's going to give vision of Gambit, but to no avail, because he's just simply going to come around. Did get a wild card on towards the bound. That simply puts one single basic attack on Darren. But you can see he's got Renian's Omen complete. He's pretty tanky. Spectral Cal on there as well.
Yeah.
Doesn't really do much damage towards him.
And with this all down from Overpower, it will be hard for him to join in on the target. Jankos decides to lock down. Therefore, make it very hard for Rocket to just instant kill whatever squishy they're going for. And Jankos might be in trouble.
Jankos puts himself a little bit out of position there. The shield was already used. Darren pops that ultimate as well on towards Rocket. Forces him away for now.
Awesome win. We see all the pingers. Darren going in.
Darren, caught with the Dark Binding. Diamond might be able to flank around and catches. Held towards them. Agony's Embrace does lock them down. The Culling coming out. Everything being used. But that hook from Edward was sublime.
Big bust
to face. Edward Overpower out from the pack. Fantastic stuff.
Nice hook here. Going back towards the Baron. They still have all the pink wards. Let's see if they just want to try and bait Rocket to move in once again. No, they are actually starting it, so they're definitely going for the Baron.
Well, everybody can fly across there. The Lantern used on Diamond pulls him across in towards the pit. The rest of Rocket going to react here. Of course, Jankos is rushing straight back in. Has got a Song battery available, but he's going to have to get in very quickly. But that's not going to be enough to lock it down. It's going to be Celebar that locks it down. The AD carry on towards it. Vander trying to get away from this one. How the hell do you let an AD carry
steal it towards it?
I have no idea. Bottom turret, that's going to have to get defended. And Gambit, well, despite the great advance that they had, they let Baron go to a single shot from Celebar.
And both junglers still have Smite. From after the Baron fight, both of them had Smite ready. Diamond just used his on the Rift Camp. And for 1 second, I thought Genji was the Lucian. So I was like, hey, you got it. Never mind, Rocket actually managed to steal the way here. Big stuff for them. Keeping them in the game, because they were starting to fall very far behind, but with this Baron Shield from Celebar, again, the guy's been playing really well lately. They're still in the game.
You gotta wonder how
both jungles had Smite.
How an AD Smite gets used. Both of them making mistakes, so it's safe to say nobody's coming out clean from that one. Nope. Nick's gonna get himself the blue buff, and once again, now with the Baron down, that objective no longer available. Let's see what Gambit can try to get from this. They made some good plays there. They had good ward coverage, and they put a lot of pressure on towards Rocket.
Just look at the ward still in
Big
the jungle.
Boss Eddie, I believe it was, you shouted out for Edward, managed to make the hooks on Overpower, created that opportunity. Let's see what they can make with the next one.
Yeah, I remember Edward when he went up to me and said, just call me Big Boss Eddie when I kill you. And I'm like, oh, I respect that.
Crepo has said many times, actually, you don't discount Edward because he'll just spank you in the lane if you try and badmouth him. At the moment, he's doing 0-1-6. Not too bad. And in fact, that bottom lane was quite an area of fights. As it stands, Vander's out of position. He's got no flash. And if he gets locked down around this side, he is going down.
He's going down. Sas is still pushing up here. Guardian Angel now onto him as well with the blade. So pushing on towards the tower. Does have teleport. He needs to come back and help the team here.
Well, the Kulin's going to be enough to help out. He's going to back to base. Edward not landing on the hook this time. Teaching that minion who's a lesson.
Probably bad mouthed him.
Dish. So 12-7 right now. And Gambit with the gold lead now eventually taking that from Rocket's paws. But Gambit, they are struggling. Every time they manage to do find a kill, get an objective doesn't really follow. They try to push in. They're trying to just go route one, honestly. They've got a big wave down the bottom lane, and now they're actually going to focus and rotate down here.
And have been winning the fights, also because Rocket have put Jankos on one target and everyone else kind of went on different targets, so they could never single someone out, which they really wanted to do with their comp. And therefore, they never managed to kill anyone in these fights. And Gambit now going towards the tower. Sazz might be an issue.
Sazz is hooked up again. Now Bloodwell, so many times it gets caught out. This time he goes down. He has got his Guardian Angel, remember, as well. That's actually going to be the Guardian Angel that goes first instead of the Bloodwell. That's going to be the turret going down. Gambit finally getting an objective.
And he'll keep pushing here. You have Red Buff on Genja, Last Whisper and Fintish and Phantom Dancer, so he's just looking to become stronger and stronger. Vanker's once again moving forward here. Overpower as well. We might see Rocket try and chase for something.
Tries to Vault Breaker. Almost caught Edward, actually. Overpower. Cutting across. They're looking at trying to ping it on towards him. The speed up from Edward. They want to lock straight on towards Yankos. Death sentence quickly dodged by Vault Breaker buttons. Wow, Diamond popping his ultimate down there. Yankos getting the assault battery on towards him. On towards Nick, but he gets locked down. And it's another pick from Gambit.
Yeah, once again, Gambit keep finding Rocket out of position to get a kill. And now move on for this mid and hip. Without any minions.
They're going to have to tank it.
There you go. Go, minions, go.
Here they come, moving in towards you. Remember, the shields from Nick should be enough. The culling coming out, but that's not worrying Gambit right now. Now they're going to pile it on towards it. Good ultimate from Zazas forces them away, but quickly that damage is returned from Gambit, forcing Rocket out. They have another minion wave, and they're going to keep on pushing.
Genji is still very helpful here, getting some damage on the tower every single time, but you need to be careful with the binding, the stun from overpower. A lot of things can get onto you. And Gambit now backing away. Didn't actually manage to get the tower, and he will now heal back up unless they come up there very fast. We'll get the dragon, get some more gold, extend the gold lead.
Yeah, that's going to get the gold. That's going to push them back into base, spend all that well-earned gold. They got themselves a tower from that push.
4,000 gold on Genji.
4,300 gold on Genji. Crazy, crazy stuff. He's got a lot of gold stacked in there. So that's going to be some big items. Bloodthirster flat out.
Instantly buying the Bloodthirst and getting the shield now as well. So if he's the target, it's going to take a lot of damage from Rocket to actually kill him, a lot of coordination as well. Getting harder and harder for them to actually lock someone down. Banshees on Darren, even actually picked up a last Whisper now on Aurelia. So Darren looking to destroy Celebi if he does get the chance. And knows he can actually tank up the damage from Rocket.
Couple of pots picked up by Gambit this time. We'll see when they make a play. Edward getting a brilliant pot on him. Okay, on Thresh, why not?
Sure.
Sure, why not?
I mean,
Fortitude was picked up by Genji.
The AP, the cooldown reduction, everything helps.
Yeah, everything.
I mean, cooldown reduction is very good on,
yep,
on Thresh. There are more hooks, though, a bit.
Totally, and when he's got the gold to spare, why not? Look at it, double giant's belt as well. Trying to get that Randy's Omen complete. Stacking out the hell. Big Eddie going in.
Oh, Yankos,
look at that, though. Genji using the 90 caliber net to draw him completely out of position. The cooling going down. Darien tanking up the entirety of that damage. Bloodwell going down.
Genji didn't take any damage.
Zazas on there. You can see they're focusing on towards him. Nick's trying to run away. Overpower tries to come around the side. And Gambit just say, you are out of this fight right now. And they pile back onto Rocket.
Look at Genji here. All the shields for him. Gets the tower now. Onto an inhibitor as well. Everything was used from Rocket. He managed to flash and net all the way back behind the rest of the Gambit members. And then the shields from Nick came in. The Wild Growth. Everything was used on Genji. He stayed alive. And while they didn't kill anyone, they still won the fight and took inhibitor.
Yet another wild destiny from Overpower. He's a little bit off on this one. Look at that gold, the swing. Rocket had themselves a good advantage, almost a 4,000 gold built up at the 30-minute mark, but now at the 45th minute, we can see Gambit ahead by 6,000 gold. Rocket,
similar to team fight,
curing the blue buff for Overpower. It's important. His destinies have not been on point, but could still turn something around. But again, the focus in that last fight, very much askew from Rocket.
Yeah, they can never really get to Genji, and once they finally get to him, Bloodthirster, Nick as well, Edward's Lantern in case he needs it, multiple shields, Face of the Mountain as well. It is not fun to be Yankos, because every time you go in, you know, there's a very small chance you actually get back out.
I don't think Yankos was having fun from the very beginning, if I'm honest. His face said it all in their pick and ban phase. Look at Diamond, waiting around the side, wants to flank in there. Edward also clearing things out. Yankos has been found. You can see Diamond locking on towards him, putting some poke on towards Hate Spikes, doing the damage. Yankos looking to turn it around. Good Darbine in lands, but the shields immediately built up by Diamond. Keeps him safe.
Rocket did have the mid-game power spike with Lucian, even with Vi, where they could try and set something up, but they simply lost the fight. Nothing more to it, and Gambit now starting up this Baron. Didn't get the last one, Celebi stole it.
Baron going down very quickly, Nick caught out, Zonya's Hourglass being used, they quickly peel off this one. Diamond goes in, it's going to be Yankos versus Genji in the Baron pit actually. It's Genji tanking up a lot of that damage, but now they lock in towards it. Darien locking on, Yankos having to use his Vault Breaker to get out of there. Quick court turnaround onto Overpower, and Gambit re-engage on Baron.
really want to take down this here. Yanga's gonna recall to base. Only Vanda and Selava left. No, actually, cancel Aaron.
Hook on Vanda. Ace and a hole coming through. Eddie dodges out of the dart point. Selava looking to finish things
TV
off
from
here.
Nick's
going to get caught out. A lot of damage from Selava there, but look at Genja. He locks in towards it. Zassa's jumps on him. Genja goes down. And Selava picks himself up the kill. Gambit are very low on hit points here. Rocket really not going to pursue. They could really do with Overpower being alive.
They did, however, manage to stop Gambit from doing the Baron and got the kill onto Genji here. Good binding and Sasa's jumping in. Genji went forward, thought he could actually get a kill here. Backfired. Delaying the Baron. Should still be the target for Gambit once they get back out here. Just gonna see once more. Banner was the target first wave, but actually didn't have to back away. Everyone else is taking damage from the Baron from Gambit here. We do see Genji going forward with the red buff. Feels like he can get a kill. Binding and Sasa's jumping in. And then Celeborn managed to pick up the kill. Lucian in the late game, who is still doing a lot of damage. I mean, Lucian is not bad in this late game.
Absolutely, he has tons of damage. Just look at the stacks that he's got out there. Of course, Infinity Edge, Bloodthirster, Zazas, no Bloodwell available this time for you. Guardian Angels is up. Nick chooses not to pop it.
Oh, he can still get it.
No, now they're going to try and turn it around. Assault Battery used. Nick's in trouble here. Yanko's putting down the damage. There's going to be Overpower. Wild Card's not going to catch up towards him. Well, Zonya's is going to be used. It tries to delay the damage, but it will be a kill. And now, with two members down, Genja just respawning, Rocket can move for Baron.
They should actually go for it here because they've been so far behind. Getting this Baron would be huge for them. The minions should be able to deal with the super minions in the base, and they are starting it. Genja running from base now. Nick, he won't even be close.
Darian could potentially, if they don't get on towards this Baron, teleport in towards that base. It would be potentially a wiser move. A good hook on to Zazas. He's still got that Bloodwell. Darian gets locked up by the Dark Shield. But the gain, the catch of Darpining instead.
Oh,
they're
going to
go towards it. The smite this time around is secured by Yankos. Darian goes down, and now Gambit are dropping like flies.
They're chasing on here. Yankos still going for it.
Diamond's going to get taken so low. Yankos will finish him off. Quick blow on towards him. Genja gets exploded. Gambit.
Wait, they can go for the base now.
Like flies. There's an inhibitor turret going down in Rocket's base. But Edward, he can't back away. Sullivan's going to keep on him. That's not potentially something I would have done for Rocket. They should have run for the base.
There was no minions though. I'm not sure if they actually wanted to tank the tower. They will go for the top lane. At least get a tower here, maybe also the next one. They have loads of time, 40 seconds on Darren as the first one, except for Nick, of course, coming out all by himself.
Zazas clears out the super minions back in his base. That's the
should
tower
be
for Rocket.
It has to be an inhibitor.
On pushing here, 30 second death timer, just Nick to try and defend it. He can clear the wave, but you can see Rocket happy to tank this one up. They've got a Baron buff, they've got the health regen, they've got the minions, and they push on through for the inhibitor.
But they get Nexus tower too. They're going here, they have cannon minion.
They may be able to get this one down, at least one of them. It's still a 15 second timer on Darian. Nick's doing anything he can to keep them away. They're going to keep on towards the next tower. The second Nexus turret, that's going to fall. Cannon
in the winning.
5 seconds.
What the hell?
Putting on towards it. They're going to take down the Nexus. And Rocket, just like that, turn on the power and take down Gambit. It's a dreadful, dreadful week for Gambit fans. 0-4 in Super Week.
Again, Gambit really, really should just let Rocket take the Baron. After Nick died up in his top lane, backed away from it. They went in, trying to get the kill. Everyone ended up dying for it. And this was just a series of Gambit mistakes. Genja first got caught out, he ended up dying. Nick in the top lane tried to kill Sasa, so Poppy's Guardian Angel, he died as well. And then the team went in to try and stop the Baron. And all of a sudden, Rocket winning the game, even though they lost every single team fight throughout the entire game.
You only need to make one mistake when you're close to the 50-minute mark, and that is exactly what Gambit did. Rocket make them pay, and they are now 7 wins in the last 10 games.
Yeah.
That is actually very good form, considering
looking very good.
What we've been talking about Rocket. They've struggled. You know, they've always had long, drawn-out games, teetering on the edge, but they keep coming out on top.
They keep it cool in the late game. They keep going for the chance as well. They stayed around Baron even after they lost a member, managed to get a kill on Genja, and used it then further on into the game here. So yeah, 7 wins the last 10 games. I mean, looking very solid now as a top 6 team and going towards the playoffs. It's going to be very hard for both Gambit and Copenhagen Wolves to catch them.
Yeah, far from convincing result, but nevertheless,
a win is a win.
Secure. A win is a win, no matter how you do it. Fantastic stuff. Gambit, where do they go from here? 0-4 in Super Week, slipping down. And as you mentioned, the Wolves actually picking up wins. At the start of Super Week, they were tied down in 7th place, I believe it was, with Rocket.
Yeah.
Now they are way out of position from Rocket. Rocket going 3-1, I want to say, in Super Week, I believe.
Yeah, they did. Good Super Week for them. And for Gambit, I mean, losing a game like this one, if you had been like SK or Alliance, yeah, in a good position, you had said, ah, okay, we messed up completely. It sucks. We had a good game. We messed it up. Let's move on. But Gambit's case, because they really need these wins, it's just such a hard situation to be in.
Yeah, it hurts.
They played well.
It hurts for a team that has done so much in the League of Legends scene. They probably...
They're legends, no matter what happens.
Second to
Fnatic,
they are the most successful European team. No question.
Gambit, Moscow 5, whatever you call them, Empire, they are legends.
Empire.
Well, all the way back in the day.
Long time ago.
Back in
only
the day.
The qualifiers, they were known as Empire. True. But everybody knows it.
But they are legends, and they helped set up the scene.
Yeah.
We just have to say it.
Let's hope they can sort themselves out after this Super Week. We're going to head over to Shox and Quickshot, who are standing by with Vanda from Rocket.
Thank you very much, D-Man. I'm indeed joined by Trevor one last time to talk to Vanda at that victory over Gambit. Congratulations, first off. 3-1 here in Super Week, something to be proud of. Let's break down the game, and I particularly wanted to ask you about the movements around Baron and Celeverse stealing it and how it brought you guys back in the game. How central was that?
Yeah, so it was really hard for us to control the vision around Nashor because they have Lulu, Thresh, Irelia, Evelynn. You can't see Evelynn, of course, and with Lulu's speed, Thresh is really good to pick someone off. So it was really hard for us, but luckily we managed to overcome this.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you guys seem to be struggling for a long period of the game, but you held off, you defended against Gambit. 3-1 on the week, losing only to Fnatic, the team that went 4-0. What's your opinion and what's your feeling like, considering this is a pretty positive turn for Rocket?
Well, so I think we are pretty confident going against most of the teams, but Alliance, SK and Fnatic, I think we are not that confident against them. Lately, we train much more than at the beginning of the season, so you can see better results from us. And yeah, I hope we can change the bad streak against those top three teams.
Well, that practice is definitely paying off. I have to say that I certainly also see the difference in Celeverse's performance really stepping up here as well this weekend. How have you noticed a difference in playing with him and seeing him maybe be more aggressive in these games?
Well, I think we could have killed them once on bot lane, but it happens. But yeah, I think Celeverse definitely is playing much better lately. Since London, I think he really, his form really went up. So I'm really happy for him, and thanks to him, we can win.
Now, I do want to expand on that just a little bit, because Celeverse has always had the ability to do well, but struggled at the beginning of the split. Is it a motivation thing? Is it a training thing? Is it the patch that is working in yours and his favor? You know, really break it down for me as to what is helping the two of you guys return back to a dominant bot lane.
So, for me, I'm playing really a lot now. I wasn't playing that much before, and I think I can see that I'm doing much better now when I just train really, really hard, like other top supports, like Yellow Star. He's doing really well, and he's playing really a lot games, so I just try to do the same to get to the good form. And I think for Celeverse, I don't know, I think he was always doing okay, but he never got any credit for our wins. Maybe because he was just playing always those safe champions like Caitlyn and standing behind. So he's always doing his job, but now when some members from the team maybe are not doing that great as before, you can actually see that Celeverse is doing great.
Just very quickly before we move on, you seem quite positive and quite happy about your performance and thinking about the team. But when we spoke to Overpower last, he seemed quite saddened by the team's performance. Is there a difference in mood between each of the players and how you feel about your team's performance at this stage in the split?
Yeah, I think everyone from the team has a bit different mindset. Like, I think Jankos, for example, is getting really tired from the season. But most of us are in really good mood, I would say. Overpower was sad because we had a pretty big lead in this game and we couldn't manage to do anything with it. And also in London, we could have played much better. But I think for this game and against Millennium, we were doing pretty fine. We were behind and we managed to turtle the game, get back to the game and win it. So for today's game and yesterday, I'm pretty happy, yeah.
Yeah, you should be happy. It doesn't matter how you do it. You got those wins, so congratulations once again.
Thank you.
All right, now let's head back over to Demon and the Fish Show one last time for a look at the standings.
Thank you both. With 16 games in the books, here are the standings at the end of Week 7. Despite Alliance's surprising loss to Copenhagen Wolves today and then falling to Fnatic, they remain in first place now with 14 wins and 4 losses, but no longer have a shot at Cloud9's record.
And speaking of Fnatic, they had a perfect Super Week and they remain in a tie for second with SK Gaming. Both teams now have 11 wins and 7 losses. And then we have the Super Hawk Crew in fourth place at 10 wins and 8 losses.
And with every Super Week, we see a lot of impressive gameplay, and that makes it harder to choose our OP players. But we have narrowed things down to these 5 after our 16 matches. First up for me in the top lane, it was Soaz. He had 33 assists, the most in the top lane. He played Lee Sin versus Aatrox, Aurelia versus Aurelia and Yorick. By the way, Yorick was a crazy one.
Yep.
He pulled it back out, but more importantly, he played Ziggs versus Jax.
The guy plays everything in his top lane, we just have to say it. Next player is going to be Impaler in the jungle, being part of 77.8% of the kills for Super Hawk Crew this week. Most for any jungler actually in this Super Week, so very strong performance. Of course, he went 8-0-9 as a Elise. And we also seen his Jarvan a few times. Not too sold on it, but he's been playing a great Super Week.
Yeah, we were calling him out at the start of Super Week, and he has responded, that's for sure. Alongside him is another teammate. It is Selfie. He went 17-11-40, a 5.18 KDA overall, and a fantastic performance, of course. He managed to get his hands on Cassidy in there, pulled out a Ryze, a Yasuo, and, of course, a Lulu. Very good performance, helping Super Hawk Crew go 3-1 this Super Week.
And then we have Reckless as our OP AD carry of the week with 24 kills, most in the Super Week of any player. He only died 4 times. So, like we normally see, Reckless playing very safe, staying alive, but also being very aggressive this time around. We've seen Vayne, Lucian, different AD carries, and really been a solid performance for him.
What's an AD carry without a fantastic support? Yellow Star alongside him, 52 assists this Super Week. And impeccable stuff. 89.2% kill participation, the most in a Super Week. He played, of course, Morgana, Nami, Thresh, and Zyra. So 4 different champions, and yet pulls out 52 assists. It says 62 on the graphic, but we're told it's 52.
And what a performance. I mean, he's the guy who sets up everything for Fnatic, the wards as well. He's the guy in control of it. And I know he's the guy who times everything and makes a lot of calls. Overall, such a good performance.
And of course, from those 5, we have to pick Yellowstar as our MVP for Week 7. Overall, he has been magnificent. A 9.67 KDA overall, as we mentioned, playing all of those different champions. He helped his team go 4-0 this perfect Super Week.
His synergy with Reckless, it also gets better and better. Everyone you talk with, like, oh, the Fnatic bottom lane is so, so strong. Such a good performance.
Well, let's take a look at him in action and listen to him taking the action calls against Millennium.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our final day of this Super Week in the European League of Legends.
Well, that's Joe Miller. He is hot on the action, that's for sure. Yellowstar, though, absolutely magnificent performance nonetheless. Sorry, we can't have the clip for him. The action is going to be continuing on Friday as the North American LCS will be kicking off their Super Week. It's going to be a massive game to start with. LMQ are facing Cloud9.
And the first day of 5 matches will close out with Team Solo Mid taking on Curse. And those games start on Friday at 9 p.m. Central European Summer Time, 12 noon Pacific.
And the European LCS will return next Thursday, beginning with Rocket versus SK Gaming.
And then we'll end the day with Millennium taking on Alliance.
And those matches will begin next Thursday, July 10th, following an all-new LCS preview show at 5:30 p.m. Central European Summertime. That is 8:30 a.m. Pacific. And now for myself, Deficio, Quickshot, Shox, Joe, and everyone else on the LCS broadcast team. GG, thank you for joining us. And this Super Week has been fantastic. We will see you soon.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our final day of this Super Week in the European League of Legends Championship Series.
It's the final countdown.
Dun, 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 dun.
We'll see if Tabs can get away.
Oh, there is the flash going to come out. But they managed to land a Q, and then they kick right back into Kautard, and will finish this one off.
This is exquisite play for Copenhagen Wolf.
Oh, it's like Mime in Swedish.
Mime.
Or like the Swedish pronunciation.
Mime. 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 Mime.
Don't forget words and talk a lot.
And kill them.
And kill them, yeah.
And there is Kurt diving around as well. Solar Flare not going to be the most impressive we've seen out of J Reed, and that might cost Millennium. They are going to be losing men left and right. Carnex is going to struggle. That's a good kick, but it only prolongs the inevitable.
We can go on then.
He missed. Okay, okay.
And Diamond, Niku, Genja, Edva.
There's the wild goes being used. It went on to Diamond. Jankos gets focused on. Good Zonya's coming out straight away from Nick there. Did focus on picking in that one. You can see Darien locking in towards it. Salavar caught out. He's going to get locked down. Nick gets him.
You saw my E-flash on main. It was like...
You know.
And it was not necessary, but it looked cool.
Fnatic chasing on this one. If they get the goal, they can finish the game right now. They're pushing on through. Wicked's going to get taken down. He's got no wild growth available. He's going to get caught out. Tabs gets a Q